So I'm getting ready to record a video on Hopper's Cabin, and I found this piece. Not sure where it goes in the mock. It fell off at some point. It goes somewhere there, but I'm not sure where, so. Yo, what's up, LEGO fans? Welcome back to my channel. I'm super excited to show you guys what I've been working on for the past couple of weeks. This is Hopper's Cabin from Stranger Things, based off of Season 3, and it took a lot of time, as you can probably tell. Giving it a good old spin, I did not add a roof because I ran out of pieces, to be honest, but this build was super complex to figure out. You may not even realize it, but don't worry, we'll be diving into some of the details, showing you how I built it. We'll start with the porch. The porch has a little roof that's built onto a hinge piece. You can take it off, and then giving you a better look at the porch. I worked really hard on this one. You can see the door. You can also see tiles that are half put on, half pointing off. I even put some broken brown tiles to simulate, you know, the old wood. And then you can see some dark gray stone simulating the foundation of the porch. And then we'll put that back on and give you another look at how it looks, you know, normally. And you can see the roof of the porch just has, you know, tiles and studs. In this show, they add a new portion to the cabin, and that is where Hopper stays. So you can see that portion looks much newer. It uses tan bricks instead of brown, which gives off a more modern vibe. And I'm using a basic technique, you know, it's just studs and then putting tiles over the studs to give it a sort of cabin-like feel. Alright, continuing to move the mock around, you can see I added a lot of exposed studs and tiles to the rest of the build to give it an old eccentric type look. So I'm using the pieces that come in brick heads, but they alternate facing one direction and then facing another direction so that I could add stuff on both sides of the walls. You can see on the inside I have dark tan, and then on the outside I have, you know, brown tiles and plates and stuff. Popping off a little corner of the mock, you can kind of see what I'm talking about. It's a little hard to explain. It took a while to get it just right, and there are some spots that look worse than others, but overall, I think it really gets the effect across. I didn't want to do two layers of bricks because that would limit the space, and I was already pretty limited with how much space I could use. For the terrain, it's just basic terrain work. You can see greenery, plants, etc., and then dark green and regular green bricks and plates just to give it the green foresty vibe. I thought about trying the mixel joint technique, but I haven't mastered that yet, and I wanted this mock to be as good as it could be, and so I went with what I knew best, and I think it turned out really well. You can also see there's windows scattered throughout the mock, but I did limit how many windows I could put because they're actually really difficult to put in there. And then we're gonna head into the interior. I think that's the pride and joy of the mock. The layout's pretty accurate. It's not exactly how it should be, and you can see I have a custom 11 and then a custom Hopper off to the side. We'll take a closer look at him later, but you can see I have a lot of different furniture, stuff that you see in the show, Hopper's chair, a couch build that was really fun to do, a kitchen. You can see beer bottles all over the place. You can see the table that 11 and Hopper eat at. You can see an interesting stove build that took quite a while to design. It's actually really cool looking, in my opinion at least. And then you can see the door into 11's room, and then sort of a cloth that hides Hopper's area. Looking at the custom Hopper that I got from minifigs.me, he looks pretty cool. I like how these guys turned out. They were expensive, but definitely worth the purchase in my opinion. The interior was really hard to do because there aren't that many well-lit reference pictures, so I'm sure there's inaccuracies all over the place, but I hope that it's close enough to satisfy your hunger for Stranger Things. And looking at Hopper's room a little bit more closely, you can see some accessories, all that kind of stuff, just to make it more lived in. And then 11's room is pretty cramped, but pretty accurate. The sand green walls were really hard to do, as you can probably tell. I do not have a lot of sand green bricks, only sand green tiles. It's kind of sad, you know. But overall, I think everything turned out okay. I think this mock is probably the favorite of my mocks that I've done. Originally, that title was held by the my previous Stranger Things build, which you can check out in the iCard above. That one was really fun to build, but this one topped that. A lot of time and effort went into this mock, so I would greatly appreciate a like, you know, share it around. I want this video to do really well because it took a lot of time and effort. Don't worry, I'll be posting mocks more regularly now that I've got this big project out of the way. I've got one in the works as we speak. I'm excited to share it with you guys, though it is much smaller in scale. But that's everything I got to say for this video. Oh, and also I'm an A-fall now. All right, bye.